So if everything is all right, we are live now here on YouTube. It's Thursday, the 3rd of August, if I'm not mistaken, and we are going to record together the Bach World Temperate Clavier Part 1, so Book 1, Number 1. Now we are going to record Number 5. Now we count Number 6 and 7. I have to really think because it's confusing. We were doing 1 to 8 these months, and there's Anya with my tea.
Hello. Good evening.
Little bit afraid of cold hands, that's maybe the most important thing. It's warm and it's humid.
Yes, but it's very warm.
Very warm, okay. Be careful, but because otherwise it will be very little bar.
Okay.
Anya is going to the kitchen, she's in the chat as always. And so we are going to record the D minor and the E flat major. That's how I remember them, those pieces. So, they are going to be released on Tuesday, next Tuesday, and the Tuesday afterwards. Before I dive into the chat a little bit to say hello to you, I should not forget to say and mention that, as some of you might have seen me doing a small mobile live stream from within the Hoxton Chapel. You know, that's the chapel I'm sitting a lot in front of lately. I'm going to organize a live concert there, the 29th of August. We don't know the time yet, but it will be in the evening, 8 or 9 o'clock in the evening. So that concert will be the Bach World Temperate Clavier 1 to 8 on my clavichord in that chapel with a live audience, live broadcasted, live streamed actually on YouTube. So it will be a major event for us. We were thinking already for doing a live stream where I would play live for you the pieces that I've been recording during the summer months. So the latest Tuesday, the 29th of August. And Anya and I were saying, why not stepping up a little bit and going to that chapel? Many of you have asked me to do something there, and that might be a good opportunity to combine those things. So having the live stream and having me perform there and with a live audience. So if you happen to live not too far from Belgium, or you just are so enthusiastic that you take the first plane, no matter where you live on this planet, you're actually very welcome here to witness that with us. So Anya and I are figuring out how to organize everything, adding to that maybe the next day something for you if you are staying overnight somewhere here in the environment, so that we can meet in a more quiet way, a more less stressed way than before the concert and the live stream. It's a lot also technically that plays along with that. So take your agenda if you are interested to that, and make a note of 29th of August. I will be giving more details in future videos. If you're not already on my email list, there is a link in the description box. That might be the best way to be informed on all the latest details, because that, of course, I can address some issues and some elements in videos, but an email list is a more easy way for me to be concrete about where the address is, what the time, and the things like that. So that's it. So before I dive into the chat and welcome you, if you are new here to Authentic Sound, my name is Wim Winters, and this channel Authentic Sound is all about sharing the beauty of the music from Bach to Beethoven. The word discover is guiding me, in fact, in diving into all kinds of elements, from notation to the context of those days, those times, and discover new elements, new layers even of emotion, and hopefully to inspire you as a musician or as a listener. If this is your first time here and you're interested in following that, no better way than to hit the subscribe button and also the bell icon, so you get notifications for these live streams, but also for the other videos. I'd appreciate that a lot. And now it's time to welcome you here. If my phone is working, and you know that's always a problem, but I'm getting better at it since my daughter Sophie has her own phone now and she's teaching me how to use this. So I guess that means I'm getting old. There is not so much live stream here, But normally it takes some time to, you know what, I'm going to play, then this thing can run a little bit, because I'm focusing also for the recordings, and the chat is being recorded also on screen. Don't let that hold you from chatting a lot. It's nice for the replay, for people who are not attending these live sessions, to read what we had to say. So I'm going to play. At the end of this, if you're still here with me, I have something that I could share with you, maybe for next project, and just ask for your opinion a little bit. So, if you're still here. There we go. I drink a little bit of for my tea. Oh yeah, I have to switch on the cameras. That might be a good idea to record everything. Anya?
Yeah?
We're going to start, I think.
Okay.
So that's the main camera. That's a lot. I have to switch this manually. And check the focus. I like one device tonight. And the reason for that is very simple, that my youngest daughter, she's 5, almost 6, she's watching some movies upstairs, holiday, so normally it's bedtime for her, but not tonight, of course, in the summer months, and why not? Okay, I think everything is running, and there we go. Thank you. Returning in a few seconds, let's just put the credit roll here. Okay, so the credit roll for the patrons for Authentic Sound. If you have not heard from that, for the just switching off the camera now. We are now 33 or 34 people who just support the things we're doing, which is awesome actually. And there is a link below if you would like to check it out. I'm going to upgrade the intro video and the whole text. Basically, it's just a website where you can pledge an amount of money, actually. That's why I call it a cup of coffee amount, and that's great because that is a community that supports the things we're doing, which feels also great. Okay, that was a D minor. Hope you like that. The fugue is a lot to be said about, also the credit, but I'm not going to do that now. You know, we have live streams, masterclasses already, also. And I have yet to record some one-tip videos for these pieces. So just to go down a little bit, see if I can access the live stream now. Okay, there it is. And that's always going so fast. So I drink first a cup of tea. Honestly, for the E-flat major, I have a little story to tell, but in a minute. Just say hello to everybody here. Carol, great to have you. Kostas, great to have time. Andy, hope the Hagelslag is still not finished. Andy was visiting us a few weeks ago. He is from California, and he liked the Belgian chocolate so much, and you'll have some. Don't know how that's called in English, Andy, I have to say that, but it's kind of a thing you put on your, yeah, on your bread actually. And he liked it so much, we gave something with him, so, but he's finishing that now. Mike, great to have you. Alexei, don't forget that now, so I can read. Which language I don't know, it's but it's Alexei, great. And then there is another person in the chat that I cannot read, said hello. With an avatar, it is a little bit of rose color, Mac. So please let me know how I could pronounce your name. It's always nice to know. Tolga, great to have you. Carol is going to miss next live streams. How can you go on holiday and then miss some live streams? That's so you can watch the replay then if you would like to catch up with things. Okay. Yeah, Kostas writes, always complains about the notification that he gets too late, but that's YouTube. That's an effect. Is this the YouTube notification system is weird? So Kostas, if you would want to test if you have the bell icon clicked, because that will push notifications even faster. So YouTube is certainly not, for the regular videos, pushing out notifications to all my subscribers. So if you happen not to click on a notification for one of my videos, which is totally understandable because we have daily videos now, but if you skip two or three, YouTube stops sending you the notification unless you hit that bell icon. And the reason why it's doing that is because if it would send notifications to all people for all videos, for all subscribers throughout all their channel, it would be something they could not manage anymore. So actually 5 or maximum 10% of the subscribers are getting a notification. And the way they click and watch actually those videos, that's how it works. In the first hour makes you to decide to send it out to more subscribers, and then they have a new kind of review after 1 day, And if the video substantially did not better than the first hour, they just push it in the trash. That's really literally how it works. If, by the other hand, the video gets a lot of watch time in the first day, then YouTube starts recommending it to other people, even not subscribers.
Can I interrupt? The live stream is shocking. They say it's not very
It's not very fluent?
No.
I'm going to check.
I'm going to say to the children.
No, so that had nothing to do with that.
Okay.
Should be okay.
It was good, and now it says that it's...
Yeah, let's see what happens. I just ran a quick speed test to see what...
So thank you, John, for saying that. I saw it after a few minutes, so...
So I'm running a speed test, let's see what that does.
Yes, that's a strange thing to do. But
I sound very technical now. There's the clavicle guy who occupies with computers, but it's slow.
Yes, I don't know why it is.
It is slow.
Should I connect you?
No, it's okay again.
Yes, it was okay when I came watching, and then it was not okay when I came the second time.
So I did a great job just by looking at it. I don't know what that was. So that's YouTube. So John, thank you. See you just appearing in my chat here. Yeah, Andy explained what it is. Okay, the hagelslag. My aunt Rita also says that the stream is standing still. Costa's video is okay, so we're happy. Karel, the most important thing from the Netherlands and whether the Stroopwafel, but be careful now, because the Netherlands is not Belgium. We speak the same language in the north of Belgium. And actually we make jokes between each other because we were kind of occupied until 1830 by the Netherlands. Actually Belgium did not exist, but we were kind of given to the Netherlands. It's a kind of buffer in between Germany and France. It was a decision made, I think, by the British. So very clever. And that's a whole history. Bruno, welcome here. Mike, you asked for my fingering. Oh, that's an interesting question. There are a few ways to get my fingering. First is become a patron. Authentic Sound if you are on the $5 reward level, meaning that you end up with $15, but you can set a cap to that because I, so to say, says charge 3 videos a month, not more. And then you get a scan of my fingering for all my personal score for all the pieces that I'm recording. So that's one possibility. Another possibility is, and then we're going to record, is, but that's future. This actually, I don't know if I should show you. Certainly not the cover, because the cover is just a tryout. But this is really the first tryout edition of music that you might know. I can hold it a little bit closer. I don't have a backup here, so I can't see what I'm showing you. Music by Costa. So it's going to happen. Many of you have asked if the music, Costa's music, is available. It is not, but we are going to launch and to play, record and to launch the scores of 6 new sonatas, 6 easy sonatas. I've asked him to write 6 easy ones, also for educational purposes. And if this works out well, this is a whole book actually. Just randomly chose some pieces. He has an immense amount of clavier music now. Then we're going to continue this, so then really Authentic Sound becomes an editor, a publishing house. And then also I'm going to release my fingerings for music I'm playing. That is copyright free, of course, like I'm playing from the Dover edition. And then we will collaborate with Costas to ask him to typeset in Sibelius the Bach pieces or music that I'm playing with my fingering and the videos. and maybe also make some dedicated feature specific for those cores. So actually this is really great. We went to some companies, printing companies today, to ask for quotes for a little bit more advanced way of binding. But this is actually good because it falls, you can play from it easily. So, all exciting. I have something else at the end of the live stream, but I'm not going to share it now because it would break my concentration. But if you still are there in a few minutes, we might discuss something else. But first, the E-flat major. The story behind the E-flat major is that this is a very brand new piece for me. So I did not play all Voltaire Pied de Clavier music by Bach. By far not, I think the half of it, because I was trained as an organist, remember, before my 18th. Then I went to Amsterdam, continued with organ, obviously, and I had a second instrument, which was the piano. And of course, I did not play all Voltaire Pied de Clavier then. When I had my clavichord, I started to play a lot of Mozart and Beethoven and Bach, but more the partitas and things like that. And the Voltaire Pied de Clavier as well. There's a whole story also behind that, but that's for another time, with my little Sophie at the time. So this is a brand new piece, and actually 2 weeks ago when we finished recording the previous two, I noticed that I hadn't played this E flat major. Of course I knew it beforehand, I had prepared it, but I forgot, and I certainly did not think of this piece as a very difficult one, which it is. It has a very difficult fugue. So you can judge me now, just practice this fugue for 1 week. How that works. We see how it goes. Anya?
Yes.
We dive into it deep.
No, it's still running. Oh.
The tape recorder?
Yes.
Okay.
Don't turn it off.
There's still enough tape?
Yes.
Okay. This camera needs to be, again, manually. Then now I have to dive deep, or literally, and actually take off my glasses to see the focus. I'm really getting old. That's that, midlife crisis, I guess. Okay, then I run to another problem. I need a page turner.
Okay.
But is there a possibility that you're going to do that or not? I will edit it out. Find a way.
Sure?
No, but we're going to try. That's the exciting element of doing it live. Actually not sure. How am I going to do this? I have to edit it then. You will see it in the video and you will remember. Hey, that's when we forgot to prepare his live stream. No, it wasn't. I forgot to ask Sophie. And I'm just doubting because there's a difficult piece to have in the right in the movement and keep it like that. You'll see. Okay, there we go. I will do for the tablet. It's losing a little bit of concentration. Is the connection still not okay?
No.
Well, I think the problem is that I should have rebooted my computer, the laptop, and you know, you closed.
No, here it says it's good.
Yeah, then it's just the processor of the laptop. Because there's nothing that we can do about it. Normally, I reboot the laptop and then it's fresh again. It needs its processor fully to stream the sound and the image, the video. So that's a lesson for next time. Because if we reboot the computer now, you lose the live stream. Anyways, this is a concentration dragon, really. And it's fresh for me. So the first two takes were a little bit too fast. It's talking about tempo. That's something you can measure that. If I would open this in Samplitude, so my editing software, I could see it. But it's, in reality, it's just an edge. It's just slightly faster, a little bit. And then it's just above that horizon line. And last time it was okay, but I lost some concentration. Because then you get this tension of these long notes, these syncopas. Don't know in English, syncopa? Syncopations. Those need to go, and the 16th notes need to go along with that. Both the speed, I mean, accentuation and articulation. And if that's extremely hard, this piece, to make it. I hope it's okay. Do the fugue, and now we can talk a little bit about it and about the other thing. Okay, I'm returning in a second. Voila, as they say here in Belgium. That's an extremely difficult fugue. And I could talk for hours how this is really written on the edge. And you cannot say that it is, I mean, yeah, it's Bach. I mean, it's never bad written. I mean, but the texture sometimes you can feel that if he writes in C sharp major, yeah, then even then it's okay for the keyboard, but and here it's very okay, but it is always on the edge because that's often with a three voice fugue. Those fugues are often more difficult than the four voice fugues and the five voice fugues like the C sharp minor, because the middle voice is jumping, has a much larger area to play in, and it's constantly divided between right hand and left hand. And here with all those jumps, you cannot just fall on a note on the clavichord and release it very quickly. You have to control the attack and the release at the same time. I mean, attack and then the release. So there are passages here, and there are many, where you have to jump, and the level of control here is really extreme. So, and that I was panicking about a little bit when I started to study. I normally, written a fugue in 1 week, it shouldn't be, of course, this is not a stage, you know. I mean, if I make a mistake, I can do it, or if really bad things will happen while playing, then I just make a retake. There's a little bit of natural, normal, enjoyable tension because I'm doing it live. But you know what I mean, it's not playing live. And so, but even then, it's not Thursday, on Sunday I was still thinking maybe to postpone this fugue, because it's not only the notes, it is a kind of visual recognition of those notes. That's, for me at least, important. So you play such a fugue and then search for the tempo, which is for me kind of allegro tempo here. And then of course your eyes need to adjust constantly because those notes are not, they're not on your hard drive already. And then typically I'm going, I'm studying a little bit slow, so I followed my own method, so to say. Some of you I know have done are in the test group for my basic keyboard element course, and I was thinking myself, I have to follow that now, because make a good fingering, study it slow, then go and sleep, and the next day you start it as if that information is going from your from one drive to the hard drive, so to the memory. But that took a while with this fugue. It's only 2 or 3 days ago that I felt that it was where it should be. So that's the exciting side of being a musician, I think. And I like that also, it's a challenge. And nobody dies with my performance, you know. So, okay. Alex is here a long time ago, nice to have you, to see you back. And I was actually saying in the beginning of the stream that Kostas had time for this stream. I know he has a meeting, and the meeting has to do with the score, with the PDF of the score, so maybe they're watching both, it would be nice. So, yeah, Carl, first rule of computer science, but you're another generation than me. But although computers, I know how to work with them, but it's just to share with you what happens during such a preparation. We finally, at our upstairs, managed to have all the wires hidden. It was prepared 3 or 4 years ago, and of course the wires that were laying there for years, they remained where they were. And now, I think on Monday or Tuesday, I thought now's the moment to really, it's holiday, the kids were cleaning up their rooms and actually painting, and the attic was being cleaned. I said, now it's up, the daddy has to give the good example. So I was cleaning up these wires, and so I had also another router, so with a better Wi-Fi system, connected that, plugged into the same thing as my computer was plugged in. And if I'm doing a live stream, my computer's going down, shut it down, and I turn off the electricity because there's no need for that. And if there is a thunderstorm in the night, and it's safe. But the router was off, so we. 6 minutes before the live stream started, I said to Anya, we are on Wi-Fi, not on, and the Wi-Fi is not very good still, but before you find that, you have to switch on that electrical power, things happen. That's actually this kind of excitement, or that I like that very much, but that should be hopefully once with the studio. So, to share something with you, and then if you have questions, leave them. I have an idea to do something very strange, maybe, but it sounds actually great. And what I'm sharing you now, it should be between us, so to say. If it's the end of the live stream, probably nobody will watch the replay. I was having a very nice interview with Emily Davidson. You will know her. That's the girl who plays cello. She has a YouTube channel. And for a long time we were, because in YouTube land, it's growing an audience as a musician is of course important. Imagine that nobody would watch the videos you're making, that's pointless, right? So, and number one rule is collaboration with other YouTube creators, as that's been called like that in YouTube land. And we were planning this for a long time because her channel has maybe not as much as videos as I do, but she has a little bit the same idea of growing an audience, interacting with you. It's not only just serving or putting videos on internet, but also reading the reactions and respond to that. And so I made an interview of her, which was a kind of a big step for me, because she's talking very fast and I have to address my tempo of speaking in English to my own level. And then she did a great job interviewing me. I think that interview she took from me is really, really great. But she's playing this cello, and I was looking for some scores to go to those companies today. I was telling you about with Costas music that we're going to print, because the Dover editions, I like them very much, as I do like some others. And I took this book, The Complete Cello Suites for Unaccompanied Cello, and I thought, wouldn't that be exciting to play them on clavichord with the left hand only? And you could say, yeah, why not using the right hand? Because that would be a fantastic exercise on clavichord. They are really difficult on cello. I mean, I cannot tell because I don't play the cello, but on the clavichord for the left hand, I tried them and it is possible. It's on the edge, as the E-flat major fugue is on the edge, but they sound great. And I don't know what the time is. But if you just have 5 minutes and don't share this with anyone, no, I'm just joking. I'm just started reading, so I took this book and I just share with you some passages. It's gorgeous. And the interesting thing is that has suddenly the clavichord becomes an instrument that's very related to those string instruments. I'm telling that all the time, but now I'm witnessing that for the first time myself, that of course I know the piece is played on cello, but then you play them on clavichord and the sound is very much alike. I was calling yesterday to Joris Potvliegen, he's finishing the article on Bach and the clavichord that will go in Clavichord International, but the extensive version will go in the vinyl box. And I was just sharing that with him, and I said, is that the sound of my mic, of my telephone, because I'm hearing a cello now, so it's really weird. And it ties into also the episode I had today on Immanuel Bach, and his view, general view on clavichord solo music, harpsichord, orchestral music. The video does very well, to my surprise, or not. The comments are not coming in, but I understand it. It's difficult. It's so different than our today's view. But I was hesitating a long time to make that video. Did the last episode was a kind of a generic way of speaking on C.P.E. Bach and the clavichord and instruments. That already is something in our world today of hip. I have witnessed some situations where people didn't like me even pointing to that passage or reading it. So, but yeah, sometimes you have to step forward, and it's just Immanuel Bach who's talking, who's saying that, and everybody takes it as he or she wants. But it ties in with this. I just share with you some bars. Crazy idea. You have to find the right balance in your hand, because you cannot hesitate on those. And so on, and then like a sarabande. I like it. Maybe you should tell me if it's a crazy idea to just have a 1 month project on one Bach or two Bach cello suites, just as an intermezzo, and it's a great exercise for the left hand. And maybe also the counterpart would be the violin sonata. So if I remember well, that is it Alt-Nicole who is writing about Bach playing his violin sonata, so solo sonatas on clavichord with just a very simple accompaniment. So that might be something for the left hand, for the right hand to work on. And the great thing about this is not only a technical exercise, because that's maybe the one of the elements that we can take from that, but it's from within this solo part finding the accents, the points where you have to stand still. That's also on a cello, but you need that also on a clavichord. You need for fixing points of support, but those are also have also a musical meaning. And if you can work this out with one voice, with the help of more articulation signs than you normally have in keyboard music, imagine what an immense amount of experience you can take then playing two voice pieces or three voice or four voice, because then you start seeing and doing things differently than just playing a fugue in four voices with two hands. Here we have all the possibilities in one hand. So I might think about having a project on this. So, if you not have left me already now for these crazy ideas, then go to your chat. Andy says, I think the suites out of the fourth are the most interesting. Bach's exploring the boundaries of what can be done on the cello. You have to check. The first one is playable, but I didn't go further. And I was just looking at this yesterday, and then Joris called and he said, yeah, why not having the right hand as well? That would, of course, make it much more easy. But I like the idea of just setting there the boundaries. That's left hand only. That might be not possible with the other ones, I have to check. Well, Andy, just exercises or full-blown transcriptions, I would just play from the original score and make fingering that really works with the expression I think you would need, and see how it, and maybe work together with the cellist. Why not doing it with Emily together? I mean, might be a good idea. She has a beautiful recording of this first suite. I like it very much. It might be an idea just to share experience then with the string player. Why not? And see where the connection is. Because that's what we often forget as keyboard players, organ players, that we are imitating other instruments on our keyboards. We are singing. We are playing violin, we are playing cello, literally then. And so make this work is something that we might benefit from. I don't know how this project would develop. John, you would do it. Thank you. So it sounded well. The lute switch, yeah, that's Alex writes. That's another idea I have. But yeah, and Bach, by the way, transcribed some of his solo pieces for the keyboard as well, like the D minor. I always like, oh, with the fugue tone, something like that. Okay. BWV 997 clavichord. I assume you mean this one. I don't know. No, that's another one. So, that Carl is writing about. I have to look it up. Ivano Filippi. I like it also. And in fact, I got the score on Monday and started to play it on the piano. Yeah. I might assume that on the piano, it's a little bit more difficult than on the clavichord, which might sound controversial because the clavichord is considered to be one of the most difficult instruments. The difficulty here is the releases of the keys, because you need to have this kind of legato. Certainly these jumps, if you would do this with a fixed wrist, that's not possible. You have to go very deep. But the clavichord, if you have a key depth, that's not too shallow. And you should check. That's something that many builders want to do, because it plays a little bit easier at first. But you need a kind of falling into the key to support this. But on a piano, that's hard to do. First of all, you have a little bit wider octave than on the Saxon clavichord. So that allows me to play things like this. And also, if you have smaller hands, it's just making use of your wrist. But on a piano, falling on such a key, forte, might be overwhelming. So then you have to control even the sound of the new figure. So a constant kind of applying tension and relaxation. If I don't leave this tension behind here with a jump, the G will miss. And also here on the end, so nice. About it. So, if you say I'm not crazy, we might proceed with this, and we'll see how far we come with the production of the scores with Kostas. That's planned for September, but if this is just too short of a date, we might just implement a month with the Bach Cello Suites. Why not? Okay, so touch-sensitive harpsichords. Well, then play on clavichord, of course. Yeah, that's the thing about that. Okay. So, oh my God, it's 11 o'clock. 1 hour and 30 minutes is live stream. That was a very long one. I hope you liked the box. Didn't let you down for that. And love to read your comments in the chat afterwards. I haven't seen everything, and I think it's a nice feature that we're now recording that. If you don't mind that what you write down is being recorded, but it's just for YouTube, you know. As always, it's so nice to have you here witness these recordings. It's so much more fun than I used to do, just recording that here behind closed doors and then share the recording afterwards. You make me focus and concentrate much more than you maybe can believe. It's really true, and I can only encourage you, if you're a musician, go on YouTube and try it out with the live audience on the live stream. It's really great. So thank you for that. Thank you for your time, and love to see you back for the next live stream. Will be next, not Sunday, but the Sunday afterwards, talking about these pieces, and hopefully the 29th of August, if you are in the neighborhood. Just let me know. Go on the mailing list if you're not already there. That's the best way to have all information. And certainly the 29th, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock Central European time, something like that, will be the live stream, broadcasted live stream with my mobile phone. The same equipment as we have, but everything will redirected, rerouted through Wi-Fi to my mobile phone. And that we tested that this week, and that worked actually fabulous. So, thanks again. Have a good night or day, depending on the place where you live on this planet. And we see each other very soon. Again, bye.